this video, I'm going to make a special plaque for some special people. It's a plaque for the nurse's station at the home where my mother lived, and I'm going to show you some new techniques I'm using to make this. First of all, the plaque uses a base of cherry in which the letters Angel Station are carved with a 60 degree bit, but there's an applique of holly right on top of the cherry. And the way I'm going to do that is to glue the holly and the cherry together and then carve this out. So let's just go through how this works, showing you on Aspire. The first thing I did was to import a model of a wreath to surround the letters. And I used the distortion tool in Aspire to make the wreath wider so that this inside portion would be large enough for the letters Angel Station. So there's the model of the wreath. Then I made some vectors to help with the carving. I made a wreath outline. See right there. I also made an outline of the inner part of the wreath. Then I started to set up the tool paths. The first tool path clears out the material on the inner part of the glued up assembly. Okay, there's the tool path that roughs that out, and we'll show you what that looks like. And while I've got the quarter inch bit installed, I'm also going to do a rough cutout of the outline just going through the holly, just going through that first layer of holly. Okay, then I'll change bits to an 1/8 inch straight bit, and I'll use that to clean up this inside edge of the pocket. At that point, the holly has been cut through in the center, so we're seeing the cherry only, and I'll go ahead and cut the letters. And the letters, I'll be using some gold paint in the letters, so I've made them show up gold here on the screen. Once that's done, I'll put a 1/16 inch ball nose bit and actually cut the wreath itself into the holly. Okay, so there's the wreath. The idea is I cut through the holly everywhere except where I want the wreath, and what's left exposed is the cherry. And then finally, using that same 1/16 inch bit, I'm going to do a cutout. And the reason I'm using such a small bit is I like to get this detail. So there's the tool path. And there's what it looks like. If I take away the waste, you can see this is what the final product should look like. And with a keyhole slot cut in the back, you can hang this onto the wall. Now I've glued up a sandwich of holly and cherry between some big calls, and now I'm going to go ahead and unclamp this. And I end up with the sandwich of cherry and holly that I need. Now all I have to do is mill the holly down to the right thickness, which is going to be 0.35 inches, and then mill the cherry down until we have 3/4 inch total thickness. I've milled my work to the holly at 350 thousandths and the cherry at 400 thousandths for a total of 3/4 inch. I've zeroed out on this lower left-hand corner and did my Z0, and now I'm ready to start cutting out the pocket with a 1/4 inch upcut bit. we've got this all cut out, and now I've got a 60 degree engraving bit in here to cut the letters. There's a cutout piece. There's a lot of fuzzies on here. This holly seems to cut very, you know, very fuzzily with a 16th inch ball nose, but otherwise it looks really nice. So we'll just go ahead and clean this up with a wire brush and a little bit of gouge work and get it nice. Well, I've cleaned up most of the fuzzies, put on a coat of lacquer, and now I'm using some metallic gold paint to paint the inside of the letters. Well, the work is all completed now. It turned out nice. I like the way this laminating and then cutting worked. It made it very secure. This lamination, you can see, is thin and it's on there very, very securely, and I didn't have to worry about any breakage in some of these thin parts. The lettering showed up nicely, but one of the lessons I've learned is next time I do this, instead of using a 60 degree bit, I'm going to use a 90 degree bit, because that will give a better angle, I think, for the gold to show off. Right now you have to kind of turn this sideways to really get the effect of the gold, so with a shallower bit, a shallower angle, I think you'll get a better view head on. But otherwise, I'm really satisfied. We got the keyhole in the back here for hanging this, and I think the nurses are going to like this a lot.